Now Hyman again. Bobbled the puck. Hughes fell down, though. Hyman leaves for McLeod. Hughes checks him from behind. McDavid gets the puck. Sustained pressure here from the Oilers. Darnay, long shot off that mask of Demko. Miller bumped by McDavid. Peronic fights for the puck. McDavid takes it away. Connor McDavid trying to bring it in front and then bank it off Demko, but it didn't work. Now McDavid was in the grill of Demko for a moment. And Miller and McDavid. And it's Hyman who dropped the gloves with JT Miller, who threw a hard right hand as Hyman was going to the ice. And DeGiuseppe's got McDavid tangled up. That'll draw a reaction from Ryan McLeod.
Yeah, but I mean, McDavid started all this.
With Demko, right?
Well, at the front of the net there as well with Miller after he tried that toe drag move off the post and it didn't go. And then into a fracas. Play right there. Miller comes in for a hit. Cross check to the head. Those two go at it. DeGiuseppe tries to get in there. And then Hyman comes from behind and cross checks Miller. They fight. This is a battle. I mean, this is frustration from the captain of the Oilers. Good move here, though. But I mean,
I told you he was getting under his skin.
Yeah, a couple of good shots. And then Hyman just from behind. And then after that, McDavid went over to DeGiuseppe. And DeGiuseppe was just trying to say, push him against the boards. He's not going to try to drop the gloves and pummel away at McDavid.
You're absolutely right. I thought I saw McDavid in the middle of that get a little poke on Demko, but it was all directed towards JT Miller. McDavid's not in the penalty box. He's on the bench. It's just Miller and Hyman, two each for roughing. So it'll be 4-on-4 for the first time in the game with 5.5 minutes elapsed here in the third period.
It filters down the bench when your best players lose their temper. And McDavid at the bench. Draisaitl will be out in the ice, but the Canucks were defending. They just weren't running around.
So 4-on-4. That's pressure, honestly.
And well, it is.
The way you're going,
you don't go in there thinking, oh, hey, it's point night. You go in there going, we can't mess this up, can we?
Oilers win the faceoff. Ekholm leaves for Bouchard. Now Draisaitl being watched by Hughes. McDavid threw a pick on Quinn Hughes. Now McDavid checked by Hughes. Peronic leaves the puck for Pettersson. He breaks out with Pugh Suter. Leaves Pettersson out on the left wing. Pettersson, Suter, Petsy in front. Stopped by Skinner. And then McDavid went over top of Suter after the whistle.
Well, he cross-checked him and then fell over top. I mean, this, the top guys for the Oilers are unraveling. They gave the puck away in their own end, pardon me, in the Canucks' end. And there's more pushing and shoving going as Hughes and McDavid. Hughes isn't going to let McDavid get back into it.
That's Ekholm reaching over the top towards Peronic. Pettersson was paired off with Bouchard, and it's Draisaitl and Suter in the corner.
I haven't seen Connor McDavid this unraveled.
I think I just saw Draisaitl being motioned to the penalty box. We'll sort it out when we come back. Okay. You saw, or you talked about the top players unraveling for the Oilers. That was earlier. This was on the last scrum, and both McDavid and Draisaitl are in the penalty box.
McDavid's got a 2 and a 10. Draisaitl, a 2-minute minor. Hyman was in there with the roughing call with JT Miller previously. So at times, what is their top line? The Oilers are all sitting together on the wrong side of the ice. And this will be a 4-on-3 for the Canucks to take a stranglehold if they can score here.
Well, and then if we've got this right, we'll just have to make sure that Draisaitl's in there with a minor as well, because that would put the Canucks onto a 5-on-3 when Quinn sent a liner to Hyman and Miller. Dave gets the loose puck in the corner, turns and delivers it all the way down.
Got a penalty from the bench here on the Oilers' side of things.
Here's Kevin Pollock.
Edmonton Ted Coates receives a 2-minute minor in sportsmanlike and a game misconduct.
Oh, Jay Woodcroft's out of the game. He's already departed.
Must have known what he said was going to get him tossed. Didn't hang around for the call. And if you think the top players for the Oilers are feeling the heat, Woodcroft feeling some calls haven't gone his way for his team. Gives the referee an earful as he's coming by his bench. There's Glenn Gulletson. There's general manager Ken Holland.
And there's Woodcroft being sent to the dressing room.
That will take them off the power play.